Details are emerging from the ongoing case of Jagmeet Sandhu, who has been charged for allegedly holding his pregnant ex-girlfriend at gunpoint for hours and forcing her to take pills in order to induce a miscarriage. 23 ABC's Leslie Gooden joins us in studio with new details just revealed. Leslie?
Good evening. The Kern County Court has released new documents that sheds light on the two possible motives for the attack. BPD states that cultural differences, including religion and race, might have played a role in the fetus's death. Sandhu wanted to protect his future financial interests as well. Today, we spoke with several organizations that offer resources for individuals who find themselves in threatening situations.
On December 10th of 2019, Jagmeet Sandhu entered his ex-girlfriend's apartment and forced her at gunpoint to ingest several pills to induce a miscarriage. According to new documents, race and cultural differences contributed in Sandhu's actions against his ex-girlfriend. The documents state that Sandhu said, quote, his family would disown him for having a child with a non-Indian female, and their cultural differences would not allow them to marry. Bakersfield detectives say it was Sandhu's desire to remain in good standing with his Indian family, community, and protect his financial interests, which were both motives to induce the miscarriage. According to the victim, Sandhu told her that he'd been kicked out of his family and forced out of their home once they found out she was pregnant. A police search warrant for Sandhu's phone revealed a text message sent to the victim reading, quote, my family's going to hate you. This is not the way to integrate into my family. They're just going to think you trapped me, even though that's far from the case. I don't want them to hate you. I don't want our relationship to face that challenge on top of everything else we will be facing. It'll be too much at once, and our relationship will suffer. Also, several searches were found in Sandhu's phone history, abortion pills via Reddit, and a search for, quote, medication abortion take home / FDA. And an image was found, but at the bottom it read, titled, honor kill. We spoke to local agencies who try and help with these types of situations.
We realize that in each situation, there might be faith decisions, faith traditions that need to be taken into account. But the number one thing is, what does she want in this relationship and in this pregnancy? And how can we help her? And how can we help him?
The victim states that Sandhu did not show threatening tendencies during their 10-month relationship prior to her becoming pregnant. And it wasn't until she attended Sandhu's graduation from California State University when she tried to approach Sandhu's parents, but were stopped by Sandhu's sister, who shared that they were not welcome to meet the family because her parents disapproved of the victim not being from the Indian community. The district attorney's office, who is handling the case, says they want to remind the community additional resources available to them if they find themselves in a threatening situation. One resource is the Family Justice Center that has created an additional hotline at 1-888-712-4143 for Punjabi-speaking individuals in need of assistance in legal issues, family issues, victims of crime, and more.
You know, you can call and leave a voicemail message on this confidential service, and a speaker of Punjabi will call you back and work through these issues. Now, this resource is not just for women. And in fact, some of the first callers were men from the Punjabi communities.
Again, if you or know someone who's believed to be in a potential threatening or threatening relationship, be sure to reach out to these numbers from the Family Justice Center at 1-800-273-7713. And for the Punjabi hotline, that is 1-888-712-4143. For now, Studio Leslie Gooden, 23 ABC News, connecting you.